Hello, Wolfram Pack Amigo thingies. I'm recording this from an Atlanta airport bathroom. I'm late for boarding and my flight leaves in 10 minutes, so excuse my hurriedness. My studio has sent me on a grueling six-stop business trip with a very unconventional itinerary. However, every location conveniently has a unique pizza to its name, which is the perfect opportunity for a video.
Blatant. The toilet's overflowing.
And that's my cue to leave. I have to stop at Newark? Come, Holy Spirit, give me the power to survive Newark Liberty International Airport where I am unable to. Hey, is this the CEO of United Airlines?
Yes, sir. What are you calling for?
Can you move up flight UAL-964 to take off, right now?
Why?
Otherwise, I'll be at Newark Airport for hours on end. You there?
Flight's taking off in a few minutes. Safe travels. Hello, this is your captain speaking. We have just landed in Naples, the city of the sun. Thanks for flying with United, and enjoy your stay.
As luck would have it, my first destination is also the birthplace of modern pizza. Although flatbreads with toppings and seasoning have been around for millennia, it was only around the mid-18th century the first tomato-topped pizza came along. Known as pizza marinara, this dish is elegantly simple, a bumpy crust with tomato sauce and seasoning on top. Soon after, someone had the idea to add mozzarella cheese, birthing the Neapolitan pizza, and springing a long chain of events into action that eventually led to this. Another Naples contribution to pizza is the pizza fritta, a Neapolitan pizza with meat toppings, which is folded in half and fried instead of baked. They're similar to calzones, another invention of Naples, and potentially predate them. As much as I'd love to keep talking about Naples, I have a plane to hitch to Sicily. So what did their licensing guy tell you?
Well, he said if Shlant Studios can't pay for the price hike, then we won't be able to broadcast in Europe for at least 4 months.
The bleep? You gotta be kidding me.
I know, it's a bunch of bleep and bull bleep.
This is your captain speaking. Welcome to Sicily, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel right now. Oh my god. Have fun.
Ah, Sicily. Despite having 7 UNESCO World Heritage Sites, it's most known for the pizza which takes its name, Sicilian pizza. Famous worldwide for its rectangular shape. But what if it wasn't? From a technical standpoint, what makes a pizza Sicilian is whether it's prepared in accordance with local tradition, not its shape. Which is kinda lame as hell, isn't it? Just like this price hike. And who could this be?
I used to have it all. A reservation at a fancy Italian hotel with a pool heated by a privately owned volcano and a chocolate fountain in every room. But apparently it's paramount we get to New York City as fast as possible, so we got on the first departure. It may be the city that never sleeps, but I didn't think that extended to the plains.
This is your co-pilot speaking. I'd like to play a laugh track for that amazing joke. Now, back to lo-fi hip-hop radio, sleeping simple hyphen, beats to sleep /chill2. Wake up, sleepy heads, it's your captain. We're in New York. Oh, you tired? Get some coffee and forget about it, capiche?
Yes, I illegally entered the Empire State Building. What you gonna do about it? You know the story. Italian immigrants came to the States en masse in the late 19th and early 20th centuries, mostly settling in New York City, bringing their culture, cuisine, and CD copies of That's Amore by Dean Martin with them. Gennaro Lombardi is often credited with opening the first pizzeria outside of Italy, Lombardi's, in 1905. However, it's all a big lie! Unlicensed vendors were around years before Lombardi's. NYC's government probably misregistered pizzerias before Lombardi's as businesses they were not, and a man named Filippo Malone opened an unlicensed pizzeria that Lombardi later bought. Lombardi didn't even found Lombardi's! Anyways, New York-style pizza deviated from those before it by using gluten-packed, sugar-enhanced, hand-tossed dough, a lot more seasoning in the tomato sauce, and unmoisturized cheese. Fun fact, in 1986, the United Nations voted 159-0 to declare New York-style pizza the objectively best pizza, so if you disagree, it's literally you against the entire world.
Hey, you know we have a zero trespassing policy, right?
Welp, I was planning to fly there, but it seems I'll get to Chicago via police chase instead. Chicago is famous for its deep dish pizza, whose origins lay at the Uno Pizzeria in 1943 when someone had the horrendous idea to bake a pizza in a pie dish. What I did at the Empire State Building was less criminal than this pizza. Deep dish's tomato sauce is typically thicker than other pizzas, and due to its girth, the ingredients are arranged into multiple layers. Hey coppers, there's a donut shop off this upcoming exit! Now I have to rendezvous with my studio at a little town called Idaho Springs in Colorado. If they ask me where I've been, I'll just tell them I stared at the bean too long and got hypnotized. So you're telling me I can watch Shazam and the SpongeBob movie Sponge Out of Water on the same flight? Yes, sir, and we have a plethora of other great films such as The Croods, Baywatch, and The Christmas Switch. Ma'am, this is the best day of my life.
This is your captain. Welcome to Denver. Yada yada. They don't want me to tell you this, but the rumors are true. This airport is HQ for the Deep State Lizard People. They'll try to erase your memory of me saying this, but don't let them. Don't let them. Don't let them!
I've got some time to kill, so how about a lesson in pizza history? After World War II came to a close, the birth of massive chain restaurants, American economic prosperity, and dominance of the US in foreign markets popularized pizzas worldwide. In fact, it took until the 60s for pepperoni to become a common topping, as chain restaurants such as Pizza Hut and Domino's sought toppings that were both easy to transport and palatable to most people. And we're here! This is Bojo's, the birthplace of our next pizza. In 1973, Bojo's founder and chef, Chip Blair, modified some of their cheese pizzas to use honey in place of sugar for their dough, inspired by customers who often dipped the crust into their sides of honey sauce and changed the crust to have a braided shape. Hey, we've been looking for you! Where have you been? I stared at the bean too long and got hypnotized. Lol mood. Why would you say lol when it means laughing out loud? Can't you just laugh? Well, it was nice talking to you. See you in Ontario.
Why do they look like that?
This is your captain, eh? Our arrival was 1 minute late. Sorry about that. I hope you enjoy your stay at beautiful Ontario with its beautiful milk bags.
Ugh, man, I'm tired. Hey, why is this milk bag warm? Wow, I'm in Hawaii. Everything's so beautiful. And their pizzas, oh my. Pineapples and ham on a cheese pizza, the sweet and savory flavors stimulating my taste buds, oh, this is heaven. Excuse me, but can you educate me on the history of this concoction? Of course. It was created in 1962 at the Satellite Restaurant by its founder, Sam Panopoulos. Panopoulos, you say? Where is he from? He was a Greek-Canadian chef who sadly passed away in 2017. Hold up, Greek-Canadian? Yeah, people mistakenly assume Hawaiian pizza comes from Hawaii, but it's actually Canadian. Where in Canada, may I ask? Ontario. Wait, what?
Ah! Ontario jump scare! Ah! 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 Dracula jump scare!
Jesus, man, you scared me!
I didn't ask. Anyways, I know you expected you'd stay here with the rest of us, but corporate just informed me that you gotta go forth on your own, so here's your new itinerary.
Oh, this is gonna be a long few days.
Yep, see you in a bit. Our finances and big part rest on you, so best of luck.
I guess you could say I've been Ontario'd. This flight stops at Atlanta. I gotta check on something there.
Yep, toilet's still overflowing. I discovered that these lavatories give me space to try out my beautiful singing skills, and I haven't left this one in 3 hours.
La 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 la. Dude, I don't know what you're doing in there, but I've been waiting out here for an hour.
Man, I'm just smoking weed. Can a man get stoned in peace these days?
Oh, okay. Take as much time as you need.
This is your captain speaking. We have just landed in Buenos Aires? If I had my druthers, I wouldn't be flying to these places I can't pronounce.
At the same time as the US, Argentina had its own wave of Italian immigrants. It was during this wave that a man named Juan Banchero invented the fugazza. This pizza has no tomato sauce, replacing it with extra cheese and topping it with little else than onion and seasoning. He also came up with a fugazza variant called the fugazzetta, which keeps the same toppings but fully encases the cheese and crust, somewhat akin to pie. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to meet someone. I was supposed to stay the night in Argentina, but I got the studio a rebate on broadcasting fees so great that it made me too excited to sleep. Anyways, cut to whatever funny thing our captain says once we land.
Hello, this is your captain speaking, and oh, it seems we've landed in Edinburgh. I tell you, these Scots are uncivilized brutes. I say we bring back Hadrian's Wall.
Well, would you look at that. I struck up yet another great deal, this time with one of our marketing partners, and now they want to check out this local pizza bar with me. Who could have guessed? So, what pizza does this place serve?
Oh, they only serve true Scottish pizza. The delectable Scottish deep-fried pizza. And that is?
Well, you take a pizza, but before even thinking of baking it, you dump it in a deep fryer. Don't use any batter. Take it out and enjoy.
I see. Well, sorry to cut this short, but I just remembered that I left my oven on back home, so I gotta get going. Bye. I think I've been traumatized.
Hello, this is your captain here. Welcome to Strasbourg. Enjoy your stay.
You know, people only know me as that guy from Shlant Studios, but it seems no one cares about my music career. So screw it, I'm turning this next section into a rap song.
There's some great food here in Strasbourg. I'll rap all about it in this verse. It's in a region called Alsace that extends into Germany. It has great culture. This dish of theirs fills me with glee. In French it's called a tart flambé. In German it's named Flammkuchen. Here's how to make one of them, they taste like heaven. Take a thin flatbread, some local sour cream, spread it on top. Then you add onions and mushrooms and bacon and extras, it's great when it's hot. Slice that bad boy in an oven, set temperature carefully so it don't drop. This thing is so good that I keep on eating and eating and I never stop.
Man, I don't know what I did last night, but the instant I got on that train, I was knocked out. Pretty sure some stranger carried my dead weight over the transfers. Well, doesn't matter anymore, cause I'm in Warsaw, land of femboys, furries, and femboy furries. It's here, and across most of Poland, that you can find zapiekankas, street food commonly called Polish pizza by us non-Poles. It originates in the 70s when Edward Gierek, secretary of the Polish United Workers' Party and de facto leader of Poland, instituted numerous economic reforms which opened the floodgates for small, private food vendors. All it takes is toasting a long piece of bread, usually a baguette, sliced in half with cheese, ketchup, mushrooms, and potentially some other ingredients. Though it'd be great to keep talking about Polish street food, I have to attend SOCON, you know, Warsaw Convention, and then finally break into my last location. Alright, I just crossed the Russian border by car. I came up to the checkpoint and gave the guards fake papers, but it seems they bought it, so I should be good.
Dima, posmotri na eta.
Что это такое?
Это шлевик, его виза, это более подделка.
Возьмите полицию, оно помоет его в Москве.
You know, I was dreading this trip, and it started off badly, but I've got a lot done. Single-handedly saved the finances department and explored culture and history through pizza. For the last pie of this video, I bring you the Moscow pizza. It starts with a plain cheese pizza, but adds tuna, mackerel, sardines, salmon, and onions. It's basically the sushi of pizza. But hold on to your horses, because there's one more detail that makes this pizza even stranger. It's served cold. Oh. My. God. Damn, it would appear I've been brought to a Russian prison through extrajudicial means. Well, that kinda sucks, but I'm still having a good time.
Jesus Christos, uznik zatknis!
I have no clue what you're saying, but I'll assume it's friendly. Hey, on that note, is it cool if I throw a party in here?
Uvast jest, ushe! Poslushe, zatknis!
I'll take that as a yes.
These nuts hits your eye like a big... That's... Among Us!